Okay, the other day you were given an EOC packet from the Florida Virtual School. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit so you can see it a little bit better at home. You can go online and find a copy of this. Just type in Florida Virtual School and hunt around for it. All right, this one right here says Anton joined the golf club 2 years ago. He pays an annual membership fee of about $900. He agrees to pay $30 for each game. They give you the formula. Last year, he paid a total of this amount. That's the total amount that he paid. So that would go here. That would be the total amount that he paid. So I would put, and you're looking for the number of games. So I'd put 2,065 is equal to 895 plus 30G. Draw your line, circle the G. You want to subtract 895 from both sides and divide by 30. So minus 895, minus 895, and then you want to divide by 30. So you take your calculator and you press 2065 minus 895, press equals, and then divide by 30. 39 games. And here's the answer right here. 39 games. Okay? On the next one, look right here and look carefully, okay? It says f of x is equal to this. F of x is really y. So don't let that confuse you. It's function notation. Some kids scratch it out and put y. Here it says y is equal to 14. So you're going to substitute the 14 right here. And you can see they did that. They put the 14 is equal to this. Now all you have to do is subtract 2 and divide by 3. Okay? Now keep in mind that if they tell you f of x is equal to 14, then in place of the whole f of x is 14. However, if they say f of 14, that's the x value. So for that one, you would say f of 14 is equal to 3 times 14 plus 2. So in this one, you substitute the whole 14 for the f of x. In this one, it's telling you that x is equal to 14, so you substitute the 14 right here, you multiply, and then add 2. So that's a little different, okay? So be careful with that. Memorize what I'm telling you on that. This one right here says, what is the domain? Domain is the x value. So all you do is look from here to here. The x value goes sideways. So it looks like it's from a negative 5 all the way up to a positive 3. So negative 5 to positive 3. That's your x value or your domain. If they say what is the range, then that is from the top to the bottom. So it looks like from the top to the bottom, it looks like it goes from, or bottom to the top, it looks like it goes from negative 4 all the way up to 6. So make sure you understand. Domain is the sideways, which is your x, and your range is the up and down, which is your y. All right, let's see what's going on here. This one's a little bit harder, okay? If you read the problem, they give you one class is $15, two classes $27. So what you have to do is write these as a point, okay? So the independent variable is 1, and it depends, the money depends on how many classes. So this is the dependent, this is the independent. So you have 1 and 15 and 2 and 27. You have to find the slope. And if you look right here, they found the slope. So it's 27 minus 15 and 2 minus 1. Remember, your y's go on top. This is x and this is y. So when you work this out, you get a slope of 12. They use point slope. I would use this one, y equals mx plus b. You want to substitute the 12, y equals 12x plus b. You're trying to find the y-intercept, so you pick a point. I like this one. My y is 15, so you put 15 is equal to 12 times 1. Well, 12 times 1 is just 12 plus b. So you subtract 12 and you get b is equal to 3. So your y-intercept is 3. So then you write your equation. Y equals mx plus b. Y equals 12x plus 3, your y-intercept, and your slope. Okay, so practice this one. They're going to have that one a lot. You can do it their way. I'll leave this solution on there so you can see it on the video. I like using the other formula. Okay, I only have a couple of minutes for this lesson. This one right here you have to distribute, so watch carefully, okay? Negative 4 times x is negative 4x. A negative times a positive is a negative, and 4 times 10 is 40. This is 3 times x is 3x. A negative times a positive is a negative. 3 times 2 is 6. A negative times a negative is a positive. Then you combine like terms. A negative 40 and a negative 6 is a negative 46. So now you have negative 4x is smaller than a negative 3x, and they're on opposite sides. So you want to get rid of the smaller one. So add 4x to both sides. 4x minus 3x is 1x. And then all you want to do is subtract 6, and then you get your answer. Okay, so you have to distribute, and then you have variables on both sides. Here's the last one I want to work. It says a bookstore sold 18,000 backpacks or paper bags 1 month, okay, books, 18,000. And then it says this was. Now, was is like is. So 18,000 is, which is equals, 10% less than the number of paperbacks. Less than, you got to switch them. So you're going to switch sides here. 10%. Now, it doesn't tell you how many paperbacks, so that's x. So it's x minus 0.10 times x. It's 10% less than what they had sold the previous month. Less than, you got to switch. We don't know how many they sold the previous month, so you put x, switch them. And then 10% less would be a minus, okay? And so it's 0.10. 10% as a decimal, you got to move it two places, it becomes 0.1. So you can look at their solution, the way they did it here. What you do now is combine this. This is a 1 right here. And so 1 minus 0.1 is 0.9. And then you divide by 0.9, and the answer is 20,000. All right, I'm going to pause the video here. We'll call this part 1 of the EOC practice from the Florida Virtual School, Algebra 1.